Welcome back, guys. Chris here, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look at the Bill Capture AI tool in NetSuite. Now, if you're not already familiar with it, the concept of Bill Capture is it's going to scan a vendor bill that you have received, and it's going to use OCR, which stands for optical character recognition, to look through that bill, find fields that are important and vital to then populate into an actual vendor bill in NetSuite. So I've talked about this subject a few different times in various videos. This is a tool that came out about almost 2 years ago at this point, and they've made small improvements to it since it first came out. But as you'll see, in general, I like the tool. I think it's a good idea, and I think it's definitely a step in the right direction, but you will see it's definitely not a perfect tool. They have a long way to go to make it universally helpful for all clients. So with that in mind, let's take a look at Bill Capture. All right, so we're here on the home dashboard, and before I actually navigate to this tool, I want to point out that this tool, Bill Capture, is not available on all accounts. For example, I have 5 demo accounts activated at the moment. 2 of them happen to have Bill Capture, and 3 of them do not. It depends on the module of NetSuite that you are using, whether or not Bill Capture as a tool is provisioned to your account. So just be aware, hopefully you have the ability to follow along with me, and if not, you just need to understand that it is not coming natively with your account. So if you do have it, you will come up here to Transactions, down here to Payables, and you'll find it right down here under Scanned Vendor Bills. You can also just put it in the global search and it will pop up as a page. So we'll click on that, which brings us to this tool. There's 3 major sections I want to point out here. First off, we have the bills that have been scanned are all shown down below. So especially if you have thousands of bills that have come in and you've scanned them and input them into the system, you will see these all listed out here. It shows the basic information like the ability to look at the bill itself. You can see when it was uploaded, by whom, what is the reference number, or let's say the bill number from that particular thing, the date of the transaction, et cetera. So it pulls up some key information here so that you know what bill we're even talking about in the first place. And then up from that, we do have a filter. So if you are dealing with a lot of transactions and you want some way to be able to pare that information down to maybe just bills that have come in from a particular email address or in a date range, et cetera, you can filter it and come over here and hit apply filters. And then lastly, up here on top, we have the ability to actually pull in and scan the bills in the first place. So this is what we're gonna do. And I have 2 bills prepared specifically for this video. So let's start with the first one. I'm gonna hit select files, and I've got 2 right here. So we're gonna click on this first one. So this is a PDF that I created using a Word doc. I just put some basic information in there. I deliberately messed up some stuff. I put in insufficient information in some cases, just to give you a representation of where it can cleverly figure out things and where it tends to fall down or make mistakes. So we've got this thing loaded. Now we could do multiple files at once, but we're just gonna do 1 at a time. So I'm gonna hit upload files on this. And notice it gives us some information on the top right. First, it tells us that it's uploading. And then in a second here, it's gonna tell us that it successfully uploaded. Okay. And then finally, another pop-up's gonna come up in a few seconds, letting us know that not only did it upload, but it's finished doing the scan and it's now pulled up a vendor bill ready to be created using the information it pulled from the scan document. All right, and you can see it now pops up there. So it generally takes, I would say on average, and I've tested it with a lot of different documents, it usually takes about from the time it actually uploads to when it's actually done scanning through things, usually about 3 to 5 seconds to complete that. In this particular case, NetSuite is actually running very slowly, so I had to cut out about 20 seconds for it to finish, do the full upload, and actually have something ready to review. But once you get that final pop-up, you know it's ready. So we can scroll down here, and we can find right here, test 2. Obviously I've done this a few times. So we're gonna open up, I'm gonna go over here and click review, which allows us to see this comparison that it did, because it hasn't created a vendor bill. It simply said, really like a proposed vendor bill. Does this match what you want? You can finish it off as needed and then create that bill. So in this case, we can see the pretty elementary PDF that I created, and I can scroll in on this just so we can, hopefully, I know it's gonna be very small on your page. I apologize for that. So hopefully you're able to see at least some of this information. I know it's a little blurry, But it basically pulls this information. We have the split screen so we can see what was on the original bill, what are we populating in. So in this case, you can see I put brocade at the top. I deliberately only put one word and not the full title. And it was able to figure out, and notice what it does here. It shows where it figured out this information is relevant from. And then if it can fill in the field, it will do so. So in this case, it pulled in from brocade. So it saw that brocade was up here in the top left, and then it pulled in that field. So that was effective. And by pulling in that vendor record, it was then able to figure out the subsidiary because it's tied to that vendor record. So it pulls it in. It also figured out things like I had here date and then due, meaning due date. So I deliberately put less information there, but it still figured out the date of the transaction as well as the due date down here in the bottom right. It also figured out the payment terms. I just had a floating net 30 here, and it recognized that and went, wait, that is a standard payment term that we have in the system. So it was able to populate that in. And lastly, the calculated amount, which is this total down here, and it pulled that in here. So far, so good. Let's scroll down here and see what else we have. So if I come down, now we come to the line levels, and this is the real important part of the vendor bill. This is the part that you want it to get very accurate. And unfortunately for this particular vendor bill, it did a pretty poor job of it. I've done other instances and other tests where it was able to pull in the items correctly. In this case, it pretty much uniformly got them wrong, mainly because it didn't recognize them as items. So even though you can see these items here is matching up what I put here, so on some of them, like this first laptop, I put an exact replica of the correct item name. And in some cases, I put a very shortened version or even a misspelled version and see if it could figure it out. But it wasn't able to figure out that any of them were items. It thought they were all expenses, so it put them here under expenses. It at least put in the memo line the correct things and put in the correct values in terms of the numbers, but it still messed up on the names itself. It should have come over here under items and filled in all the appropriate items because these things are actually in the system. So that's an example where, again, sometimes it works well, sometimes it just can't figure it out. So in this particular case, it got all the header level information right, but flunked on the line level information. If it had gotten it correct, we would be able to come down here and hit create bill. However, if let's say a particular field was missing and we do not have that information on hand, we could come down here to save for later, save this thing, hang it in the previous page we were on, come back when we have the relevant information, fill it in, and then create that vendor bill. We also have the ability, if this vendor bill is, if it recognizes and syncs it up with a purchase order, it oftentimes can then pull over that purchase order information onto the vendor bill in addition to the scanned vendor bill. So that is another benefit of using this system. So you get the idea. This is obviously somewhat effective, but not completely. We have a few additional options up here. We can zoom out, zoom in. We can also download this document if we want. I think you get the idea. So now let's back out of here. I'm going to hit cancel and let's do the second document I had prepared. So this is a much rougher vendor bill. If I come up here to select files, I have this one. It is not only handwritten and very poorly so, but it's also a photo image of the bill and not head on, but at a weird angle. So there's all kinds of problems with it. Let's see how it does. We're going to come up here to upload files. Again, it lets us know that it's uploading. All right, and there we have, we can see that it pulled up and successfully uploaded. And then if we wait a second, and now you can see, not only did it upload it, but it did the scan as appropriate. So with that now done, we can come down here. We've got test number one. I'm gonna come over again and hit review on that. It pulls up this very, it looks like a six-year-old made this invoice. I found it online. And we're gonna zoom in on that like crazy. Now I know you're not gonna be able to read most of this, which is fine. But also points out, the system struggles also to read some of these things as well. So what do we have here? We've got some fields filled in, but mostly not effectively. So, and a couple things that are particularly noteworthy. So for example, the reference number, if we click on that, one thing that's interesting, because we're dealing with this more handwritten kind of image of a document as opposed to a real PDF or something like that, you can see it's gonna highlight where it's finding this information. So it was able to figure out the invoice number. It listed that out here. And in terms of other things, for example, it could not find a date. So it filled in with the current date. It also wasn't able to find a vendor. I think there is some sort of vendor thing. It's very hard for me to see on here, but I think there's a Mr. Client. So it should have figured that one out. It wasn't able to read it. So, or wasn't able to figure out that that was relevant field. So it's got nothing on that. Also, one thing I think is interesting is it didn't figure out the currency, although, you know, you could figure out the currency pulling off the vendor and then the subsidiary, but you can also just figure out the currency by the fact that there's dollar bills everywhere. Evidently, the system doesn't work that way. It needs to look at it through that subsidiary. So whatever, we have that as that. And a couple things I think are particularly interesting here. Notice it says, please pay in 30 days. So it recognized there was a field on here that says, please pay in 30 days. And that is something related to payment terms. It could recognize that, which is great, but that is not a payment term in the system. Now you could say, well, that should be net 30, but it's not clever enough to figure out that not only is that related to payment terms, but also that's basically saying that that's gonna be a net 30 and then just automatically select that as an option. It would be great if it did, you know, it lists exactly what it found and then just says, well, it's probably net 30, right? But in this case, it's not that sophisticated. So it leaves that blank. It's got a calculated amount down here. So if we scroll down further to the items, in this case, it didn't just blot everything under expenses. It put it under items, which is great, but it obviously struggled to find the exact titles because this is not, none of this information is relevant to this actual NetSuite system. So for example, we have $250 here and that's related to materials. It doesn't know what materials is as an item. So it leaves that information blank, although it does pull in the fact that it's 250. One thing is interesting, if you pull in vendor bills, even if it can't figure out the item, but it notices that there's an item cost and then a total cost, it will actually figure out, it'll divide them and go, oh, clearly you must have had six of this thing, and it will put it there in terms of quantity. So that's kind of nice. So it was able to figure out these two figures, it put them, and then up above, it calculated those two things together. So again, it does some things well and some things poorly. This is something where I really just find you need to play around with it, especially in relation to the vendor bills that you actually receive and see which ones it's successful with, see what kind of things it tends to run into problems with. You might even need to work with your vendor to try to make them have their vendor bills in a way that the system's able to easily figure out what things are what, so that you can make your system and your processing of these bills much more efficient on your side, at least if you're dealing with a large quantity of vendor bills. So that's the mechanics of how this thing works. Now, one last thing I want to point out in terms of this tool is the preferences in relation to it. So if we come up here to setup, we'll come down here to accounting. And if I scroll down here, we have bill capture preferences. So we'll click on that. And it brings us to this page. Now you might expect that the preferences area has a lot of comprehensive ability to select how it should apply logic, what kinds of things it should look for, and how it should try to assume or populate the information based on what it's found in the scan document. Unfortunately, the preferences at this moment in time are quite limited. I've heard rumors that they at least have the intention of making this a much more comprehensive system where you can actually give it direction and instructions so that it can figure these things out. But as of now, it's far from that. So hopefully that does come in the future, because that type of logic-based population and sourcing would make this tool go from just useful sometimes to being universally helpful for almost all clients. But as it currently stands, we have some limited things such as what things are being displayed, like how many rows or how frequent or recent can we see the bills that have been uploaded. So that's, you know, you can use that if you want. Over to review page, we can see when you are reviewing things, how do the line categorization look, the expense line totals, etc. And then most importantly, when we come to the field sourcing, some of these features would be relevant, such as, like I said, where it links to a purchase order. Is it going to automatically create a bill from that purchase order? I generally don't recommend that. You have a few options there. You have a few options in terms of based on the payment terms. Is it going to take it based on the preferred payment terms on that vendor bill, or should we go with the scan file? You can set some of these things. So there are some things that can be useful. But in general, you can set the tax account, the shipping account, but in general, you're pretty limited in terms of the preferences that are currently available as of this tool, as I'm recording this in 2025. All right, so that's your quick look at the Bill Capture AI tool in NetSuite. If you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe. I come out with new videos every single week, not just for NetSuite, but now I'm starting to roll out other software as well, including Microsoft Dynamics, Sage, SAP, etc. So many more videos to come. If you're interested in that, please hit the subscribe button. And with that in mind, I'll see you in the next video.